And we've had Let's Talk at our school for some time. And one of the reasons why we embarked on the Let's Talk program was because our school days can often get quite busy. We have a suite of wellbeing initiatives or programs across the school, positive psychology, character strengths, and those sorts of things. But that nice one-to-one talk wasn't probably occurring. And we realized that students needed that opportunity to be able to speak, not often to a peer, but to an adult as well, to be able to share their issues. And so the Let's Talk program, training staff in that, we thought would really help foster that ability to be able to talk with adults. When I speak with leaders and we have our leadership meetings for grade six students, they would often talk about Let's Talk as the solution to some of the issues we might be looking at. And I think that has really been a support to them, that they feel they've got a little bit more control. There's something happening in their school that's not a curriculum program, but a program that's quite tangible for them. And then I think being able to become mentors themselves, they can see that this is going to support some of the things that we've been talking about. You know, my teacher listens to me, they're connected to school, those sorts of things that we do surveys on. And when we look at those surveys, what is a solution or a strategy? Let's Talk fits that bill. So our student attitudes to school survey around school connectedness was 78% positive in 2017, and now across in our 2020, and even given what happened last year through COVID, it's now sitting at 89%. And I think that's a real indication of how the Let's Talk program has addressed some of those issues that we wanted to talk about.
The feedback and benefits of being Let's Talk Mentor has been the relationships that we've been able to build with the kids that we may not have built beforehand. With being Let's Talk Mentor, we go through all of the year levels, and throughout all the year levels we've built relationships that are starting to feel really comfortable, and the kids are starting to open up to ways that we didn't think that they would open up before. The thing that I like the most about this Let's Talk program is going through the TALK steps. I think as myself, I can really start jumping to conclusions and start fixing the problems for them. But with the Let's Talk program, we're able to follow a step-by-step process to ensure that we are helping the kids the best we possibly can.
The students are loving the Let's Talk program. They're loving that there is a safe place for them here at MPRPS to talk about their emotions. We run a program for the kids to be able to come in on a Tuesday and see a couple of us in the senior yard and be able to come up and talk to us. And they like the fact that they can actually follow up with you and have a chat. So if they're feeling like they can't talk, they'll come up and tap me on the shoulder and say, "Hey, Mrs. Jones, let's go for a talk. Let's go for a walk." And then I'll know that that's the signal that we need to just remove ourselves and have a chat and get things out in the open rather than them bottling it up. Seeing kids who have gone from at the start of the Let's Talk program to being very bottled up, quite angry, not willing to talk about their emotions, to then coming up to me and saying, you know, "Can we go for a chat? Can we have a talk?" And then seeing them reflect that with their fellow peers is amazing. And I think that it's really important that the kids actually understand that everyone has emotions. And to be able to break that barrier down so early in their primary years is phenomenal, and that we've got this program in place to help guide them through these years before heading to high school is a huge achievement for the kids and for us staff as well.
I feel that the Let's Talk program will help to break the stigma of mental health in a way that it's starting to create a norm for children to talk about their problems and to share their problems and to know that other kids, or that they're not the only ones that might have something to talk about.
I think we know as school and educators that schools can be really busy, so the more adults that we can have involved in the program, the better for us. It means that we can deal with issues quickly and promptly, and it means that we can get our students back learning as quickly as possible, so extremely positive. We really want to implement Let's Talk throughout the whole school. We want it to become a part of our curriculum. So just like literacy and numeracy is a part of our core curriculum, we want the Let's Talk component of wellbeing and talking to be a natural part of our curriculum.